Have you heard about the tritium leak in Minnesota?
No, I don't even know what tritium is.
It is a radioactive form of hydrogen that is generated in nuclear reactors.
Is it dangerous?
No.
Then why are people worried about it?
Because it's radioactive.
I thought radioactive things were dangerous.
Some are. Some aren't. It depends on a few things.
All I know is that I don't want radioactive things around me or in me.
But there are already radioactive things in you.
There are? Like what?
There is a radioactive form of carbon in you and there is also a radioactive form of potassium in you.
Did they come from nuclear reactors?
No. The radioactive form of carbon was formed when sunlight hits our atmosphere, and the radioactive form of potassium has been around for billions of years.
If it's been radioactive for billions of years, it must be dangerous.
No, when something is radioactive for billions of years, then it has an incredibly low level of radioactivity.
Is the radioactive hydrogen in Minnesota dangerous?
No. It is present in very tiny amounts in water. Even if you were drinking this water, it wouldn't harm you.
So why are people worried about it?
People have been taught to be afraid of anything radioactive. Even though there are many radioactive substances around you right now.
Like what?
Well, for one thing, you are breathing a small amount of radioactive gas right now. It is a radioactive gas called radon.
That doesn't sound good. I've heard radon is bad and you should get tested for it.
In larger amounts, yes, it can pose danger. But it is present everywhere around us. So it can't be avoided. You breathe in some radon with every breath you take.
Is this because of the nuclear reactors?
No. It is because there are small amounts of uranium in the soil, and some of it decays to radon gas. It filters through the soil and you breathe it in.
Do nuclear reactors make radon gas?
No, by fissioning uranium they actually reduce the amount of radon gas that would otherwise be produced.
But you said they make the radioactive form of hydrogen called tritium.
Yes, and when tritium gets in water it is essentially impossible to get it out.
What happens to it?
Eventually it decays to helium.
Does that take billions of years?
No, tritium decays away more quickly than that. Half of it decays every 12 years.
So half the tritium in Minnesota will turn into helium in 12 years?
Yes. But half of the tritium in the whole world will also turn into helium in 12 years.
So it's always going away?
Yes, that's what radioactive things do. They are always going away. Some of them go away quickly and some go away slowly. But they are always going away.
That sounds like a good thing. I guess it will be good when all the radioactive things have gone away. Then there won't be any more radon gas.
No. It will be terrible. If all the radioactive materials went away, then the Earth would no longer be heated internally.
What would that mean?
It would mean that the inside of our planet would eventually become completely solid.
What would that mean?
It would mean that the Earth's magnetic field would go away.
What would that mean?
It would mean that the Earth would no longer be shielded from the solar wind blowing out from the sun.
And what would that mean?
It would mean that eventually the Earth's atmosphere would be stripped away and our planet would become as dead as Mars.
That sounds really bad. I guess it's okay if we have some radioactive materials inside the Earth.
Yes, we would not be here without them.
But I'm not too happy about the tritium in Minnesota.
They're cleaning it up, but really that's not necessary because it's no threat.
Then why are they doing it?
Because the public is unnaturally afraid of radiation.
Why?
Because they don't have the perspective I've given you and believe all radiation is bad. When in fact, you can now see that most radiation in the world around us is completely safe.
That is a shame that they don't know the truth. At least I now have a better understanding myself. I appreciate you telling me what you have told me. I would like to learn more about radioactivity and gain a greater understanding of which radiation is dangerous to us and which radiation is safe for us. I'd also like to know more about natural sources of radiation.
We'll talk more about that in a future video. Goodbye for now.